Hi friends, Miggi from Figma here, and today we're going to use Figma Draw to illustrate a plant cell diagram. So let's go. Specifically, what we're going to be covering is how to build out this portion of the endoplasmic reticulum. Let's begin by pressing the O key. I'm going to draw out a circle and let's center it there within our frame. I'm going to hover over the arc dot and drag this all the way so our sweep is 25%. I'm going to hover over the ratio there in the center and drag that all the way out to ratio 100%. I'm going to press Shift X. What that's going to do is swap the fill and the stroke and give us this stroke line on the arc right there. Now, let's come over here to the right and I'm going to choose a different color, my lavender color right there. I want to set the stroke position to the center and we're going to choose a round end cap. We can make that a little bit bigger. Let's set that actually to the value of 5. We're going to be able to see that a lot better now. Now, heading back over here to the middle, we can see that we have this arc. We can still adjust the start position as well as the sweep. I'm going to duplicate that. So Command D, Control D if you're on Windows, and then I can adjust the start position as well as the sweep. And once again, I can select those both, press Command D, then hold down the option and the shift key. That's the alt and the shift key if you're on Windows. I'm going to scale that down to the middle and then I can make further adjustments to make this appear more variable. I can even adjust that sweep value out a bit more. We can select this once again, press Command D, Control D if you're on Windows, scale that down and then adjust its position there with a bit more sweep. Now, to make connections between our endoplasmic reticulum, I'm going to press the P key, that is the pen tool. Then I'm going to click right here and make a little connector. If the pen tool is still connected, press escape. Let's make another little connector right there to right there and press escape. The next step, we're going to select all of those objects and we're going to come down here and we're going to union them. So in Figma Draw, the union tool is made available. It's going to put that all together as a single object. You can always double click back inside and make pen tool adjustments to further refine your drawing. Now that we have this set up, we're going to head back on over here to the right and we're going to add in a stroke value. The union is making the strokes that we have a fill. This is going to give us the opportunity to add a stroke value. I'm going to use my darker purple and here we're going to use a weight of 1.75. We do want to apply a corner radius. What that's going to do is here you can see we're going to get this nice little rounded corner on the inside of our endoplasmic reticulum. The key Figma draw feature that we're going to use over here in our draw panel, we're going to come over to effects. We're going to choose texture and we're going to take this texture panel back over here to the middle. This texture is being applied to our shape. We're going to take that radius down to a value of 0.8 and then we're going to adjust that size to about a value of 8. This is looking pretty great. We can always double click inside, adjust those sweep and start values, as well as move any of the points that we have here. I can select that whole object. I can duplicate it. I can rotate it. And I can move this up top. That is how you get the endoplasmic reticulum design for our plant cell diagram. If you take a look here, other features that we're using brushes, we're using dynamic strokes. Let me know what you'd like to learn next. And as always, happy designing.